if you don't have any option, you can really work like sa dining table, as I mentioned earlier. Pero of course, medyo mahirap kasi every time na you need to set up the table or every time na may kakain. So, syempre, you need to move all your things. You have to remove everything. And then, you have to... of course, everything will be out of place na naman. Given that, I think this is the best time for us to really set up our semi-permanent workspace at home. Para hindi tayo naguguluhan, may na-organize tayo and all. Everyone, this is Anna and welcome to my channel. Today I'm excited because I'll be sharing with you tips on how to set up your workspace at home. We all know na marami sa atin naka-work from home right now because of this quarantine. So, I'm sure during the first few week or weeks when we had this work from home set up, we didn't expect this to last this long. Kasi di naman talaga natin alam na we just thought na after like 2 weeks wala na, or after a few weeks lang okay na. But now that it's getting longer and longer, it's getting hard pagka wala kang workspace of your own. Most probably naganap lang muna tayo ng any space available where we can put our laptop and then work na kagad. So most probably minsan yung iba sa couch nag-work, nag-laptop ka lang sa couch, yung iba naman nag-work sa bed. Or most of us, nagwo-work siguro sa dining table. So, yung puro temporary lang talaga kasi we really didn't expect this to be long. So, actually, pwede rin naman. If you don't have any option, you can really work like sa dining table, as I mentioned earlier. Pero of course, medyo mahirap kasi every time na you need to set up the table or every time na may kakain. So, syempre, you need to move all your things. You have to remove everything. And then, you have to... of course, everything will be out of place na naman. So of course, when you do that, nawawala yung train of thoughts mo, nawawala yung focus, napuputol yung ideas mo. So, hindi tayo nagiging productive and we're not being organized. So, mahirap talaga. It's really a struggle. And now that quarantine is again extended, so, and we really don't know when this will end. So, it kasi pahaba na ng pahaba. I think nasa season 4 na yata tayo, season 3. And then after May 15, we will be extending again for another, like, I think they call it a general community quarantine, something like that. But anyway, it just means that we really don't know when this will end. Given that, I think this is the best time for us to really set up our semi-permanent workspace at home. Para hindi tayo naguguluhan, may na-organize tayo and all. And in doing so, of course, it's important to note that when we set up our workspace at home, we should do it correctly. Of course, hindi naman kailangan perfect, hindi naman natin ma-achieve yung perfect talaga na setup at home. Correctly meaning the best possible way you can, where it will help you be productive and of course comfortable at the same time. And also, of course, you have to use whatever you have at home kasi hindi naman tayo makakapag-shopping pa or makakapunta ng mall. So, you just use whatever you have at home. So, sa bahay na lang tayo magsha-shopping. I'm sure marami kayong makikita dyan, mga small things, mga things that you never realize na hindi nyo pala nagagamit. So, marami yan. I'm sure maraming masha-shopping sa bahay. And before we continue, if you're new in my channel, please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button and also click the notification below for more videos. So now, let's go to the 5 tips on how you can set up your workspace at home. Number 1 is isolation. Isolation meaning, of course, you have to find a dedicated place to separate yourself and work without any distraction. It's very important that wala ka masyadong distraction, na nakahiwalay ka kahit papano. If you have an available room, of course, it's a lot better para mas talagang makapag-focus ka and makapag-concentrate on your work. But, if you don't have any available room, of course, okay lang din naman. You just have to find a space where you can set up your workspace. In setting up your workspace, you just have to use any table or actually kahit nga folding table, pwede na. So, basta any table, find a space where you can work and siguro preferably in a corner of your house or on the side. So hanap lang kayo ng any space. It doesn't have to be big. Basta ano lang, enough lang siya for the table that you have. Siyempre, ideally, it's a lot better not to stay in the middle of the room para nobody will be passing by in front of you or behind you kasi siyempre medyo nakaka-distract yun when a lot of people are passing by sa harap mo. So, mas nakakapag-concentrate ka kapag yung medyo nakahiwalay ka with the rest of the family or with home activities. Ganun. And also, make sure that you're not facing the TV or the bed kasi syempre nakaka-tempt yun. So very tempting kapag nakaharap ka sa TV or sa bed kasi parang pag bed gusto mo matulog, pag TV naman parang mapapatingin ka, mapapanood ka. So make sure to avoid those areas. And also, of course, if you know that you'll be doing conference calls, make sure that your back is not facing like your bathroom door kasi baka mamaya biglang may lumabas doon na naked or baka biglang basta hindi sila ready, of course. They didn't expect na you're in a conference call. So make sure na lang na your background is safe. Basta it's important to find a space na medyo naka-isolate ka. And make sure to consider always your background just to make sure. And also, of course, para professional pa rin kahit nasa house. Next is number 2, chair. So once you're done with setting up your table, the next thing you will find is a nice, comfortable chair and make sure it has backrest because it's very important kasi it's hard to work when there's no backrest and also it will hurt your back and of course it will also affect your health. I also read na of course when you choose your chair, dapat yung you can cross your legs if you need to. There's enough space for you to do that under the table. And also when you put your feet or legs down, dapat yung feet mo should be flat on the floor. If you're really petite, so you can find you can put a stool para meron ka pa ring naapaka na flat yung feet mo on the ground para ka pa ring naka flat feet on the ground. Ideally, your chair should have a good lumbar support. So important 'yun sa back, yung dapat naka-arch yung back niya para protected yung spine mo or your lower spine. But of course, if you don't have that, pwede rin namang regular chair. Siguro you can just put like a cushion or a small pillow sa back para at least mas relax yung feeling, straight pa rin yung back mo at hindi ma-affect yung lower spine mo. And of course, better than if there's cushion para masarap and comfortable yung seat. Especially if you'll be spending a lot of time on the computer or sitting down, so chair is really very important. Again, make sure that when you choose your chair, it has to be comfortable and it has a backrest. Maybe you can just put a cushion, which is better para at least comfy yung feeling. Next is number 3, lighting. Of course, proper lighting is very important when you set up your workspace. Kasi without proper lighting, your eyes get strained easily. So, madali yan mapapagod. You will feel exhausted and nakaka-stress kapag hindi proper yung lighting. Plus, it will sometimes even give you headache or migraine. So, it's really not good for our eyes kapag hindi proper your lighting. If the space that you chose for your table or for your workspace has no proper lighting or has no natural light, then you have to provide a lamp just to be sure na may proper lighting pa rin kahit walang natural light. Siyempre, best pa rin is to have natural lighting kasi natural lighting is still the best for. So, mas maganda talaga if you can find a space na malapit sa window para at least maliwanag talaga siya during the day. And also, speaking of eyes, if you know that you'll be spending a lot of time using your computer or your iPad or your phone, make sure to do the 20-20-20 rule. I'm not sure if you're familiar with it. 20-20 rule is you have to look away 20 feet every 20 minutes for 20 seconds. So, yun yung 20-20-20 rule. It will also help our eyes not to get strained easily when you do the 20-20-20 rule. Next is number 4. Break muna. Next is number 4, organize. So, of course, you have to list down all the things that you'll be needing. The things that you usually use in your daily work, like yung mga pen, ball pen, pencil, notepad, or notebook. It depends on the nature of your work. Basta all the things that you usually use in a day. So organize them, put them all together, and then find a place or a space where you can put it. Example, if you have a shelf or you have a stool, actually kahit stool, you can put them there. Or actually pwede rin nga storage box. If you have a storage box, ang daming mga cute na storage box, diba? So you can put it there. But anyway, basta hanap lang kayo sa house nyo ng mga pwedeng paglagyan. Marami naman, kahit any box nga, pwede na. So, yun, as long as they're all organized and they're all together, so it's easy for you to work kasi tuloy-tuloy na, hindi yung pagkikilangan ka, tsaka mo palang kukunin, tsaka mo palang hahanapin. At least when they're all together, organized in the space or that you provided or the table that you chose, then maayos na sila lahat. It's easy for you to work continuously. And also, of course, if you'll be using your laptops or your iPad, phones, so I'm sure you'll be needing an electric socket or electrical outlet. So make sure when you choose your space or where you will put or set up your workspace, make sure na merong electrical outlet near it. Or kung talagang wala naman, pwede rin namang mag-provide ng extension cord. So that's part of the things that you'll be organizing para pag naglobat yung laptop or yung phone, di yung matataranta ka, doon ka pala maghahanap ng saksakan. So at least nandun na lahat, ready na lahat, all organized. And then you can just work continuously without any interruptions as well as wala ka ng mga problem pag nag-start ka na mag-work. So tuloy-tuloy na siya. And lastly, number 5 is decorate. So this is the fun part kasi you get to decorate your space. So wag naman masyadong madami, but it's nice also, of course, may konting decoration. So basta minimal lang, minimalist lang ang peg. So tama-tama lang. Maybe you can put a nice coat or a picture. So something lang that will help you be inspired and be in the mood and be productive. It's nice also if you can put a plant kasi they say plant or nature in general helps us focus and be productive. And it also relaxes us. Actually, that's why we're here. Because this is the sample setup that I prepared for you guys. So, para at least makita nyo, you get to imagine and picture the tips that I'm telling you. So, later I'll show you kung ano yung mga nilagay ko dyan para ma-imagine nyo at ma-start nyo na rin yung workspace nyo at home. So, again, yan guys yung pin-repair kong sample workspace that you can make. Actually, foldable table lang yan. So, very simple. Ayan yung computer. Of course, I have the whiteboard there. Ayan yung whiteboard. And then, my coffee, your lamp. Plant, as I mentioned, it's nice to put plant. And then the, what do you call that? Pen holder. And then, mga kung ano-anong mga anik-anik dyan. Then, my corkboard, my daily planner. And then, my coat is there. So, there. Very simple. Pero, very useful siya. So, I like it. It's nice. I hope you like and you hope you learned something from this. So, I hope you start working on your own spaces at home. Bye! So, there you have it. Those are my 5 tips on how to set up your workspace at home or your home office. I hope you learned something from this video. And if you have other tips that you'd like to add, please don't forget to comment down below. Please don't forget to like, share, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. Click the subscribe button below and also the notification bell for more videos. Thank you again for watching. Stay safe. See you. Bye.